Hey, so I'm going to show you how to add keywords to Google Ads. It's actually very, very easy, but I want to make sure that you're adding the right keywords, and I'll show you the caveats between it. So in your Google Ads account, you'll see this thing called Ad Groups here. Click on that and then select the ad group you want to add keywords to. So we're going to click this one here, and then that's going to open up some search keywords. If it doesn't, just click on the keywords on the left-hand side, and then that will open that up. In order to add some keywords, you can click on the plus button here and then just add the keywords that you want. And it'll suggest some keywords here. I don't recommend doing that. Instead, I recommend going to Google Keyword Planner and choosing out keywords based on relevancy, based on search volume. Now, I just want to quickly educate you. You'll notice that there's quotation marks here on each side of the keyword that I've got. And that's what we call a phrase match keyword. Now, I just want to explain the nuances between them because it's so important. You'll be wasting tens of thousands of dollars, depending on how much you're spending, if you don't get this right. Okay, so I've used ChatGPT, good old trusty ChatGPT. So what are the different types of keywords? You've got broad match, you've got phrase match, and you've got exact match. And so you can easily switch these between the keywords. You can select one, and then you can change the actual phrase type. So for example, you can select it, you can edit it, and then you can be like, change the match type. Okay, it says upgrade to broad match. Sometimes smart bidding is good. Anyway, let me get to it. I'm rushing it. So broad match, what does that look like? Well, broad match is usually when you don't have anything on either side of the keyword. You don't have quotation marks and you don't have brackets. You just got the keyword as is. And the reason why you would want to use something like that is if you're looking at brand awareness. You're trying to get your product to as many people as possible. Now, Google have upgraded their broad match over the years, so it's working a lot better than it used to. But in a nutshell, if you said, for example, if you just had organic coffee, you didn't have the quotation marks, you just had organic coffee, for example, then you'd be attracting all sorts of people. People looking to buy organic coffee, people researching, is organic coffee healthy? You know, you get people, research students, students in general, right? So it attracts all these kind of searches that you don't really want to bid on if you're trying to sell coffee beans. Right? Or organic coffee. You wouldn't want to just put it in organic coffee because it would just attract so many unwanted auctions and searches. And so you waste a lot of money there. Now, it does work really well for e-commerce stores sometimes because the algorithm is trained based on the buyers if you've got conversion goals set up. But if you don't, then it can be very difficult to find the right people. Okay. Now, that's the caveat to that. Phrase match gives you a bit more control, and phrase match is when you have quotation marks on each side of the word. So the reason why you use that, for example, is so that whenever someone types in like urgent plumber or emergency plumber, 24/7 plumber, 24-hour plumber, there's usually a high likelihood that that person, the intent behind their search is that they want to find a plumber near them, right? So that's one level. The second level is anyone who types in urgent plumber, and that's found anywhere in the search. So for example, if someone said, what is an urgent plumber? Not that they would, but let's for argument's sake, then you would potentially be showing up for that auction. You'll be showing, your ad will be shown for that, but also be shown for urgent plumber near me. You know, if someone typed in near me at the end, you'll still show up because you just want to show up for any mentions of urgent plumber. Okay, so that's kind of how that works in a nutshell. And phrase match is probably the sweet spot between broad and exact, which is the next one. So exact gives you all the control. So for example, if you're like, okay, I don't want to have urgent plumber, I only want to bid on people who type in exactly urgent plumber near me. And I only want to show my ad whenever someone types that in. If they don't type that in exactly, I don't want to show my ad. And that's kind of like what an exact match would be for. Okay, so let's give some examples. If someone for broad match types digital cameras, that'd be showing up for best cameras for photography, digital camera reviews, all this kind of stuff you can imagine, right? When would you ever want to do this? Normally, if you're got a like you've got a blog you want to push out and it's like covers these kind of topics, maybe you're pushing brand awareness for your camera. There's all sorts of reasons why. Phrase match, men's running shoes. Now, this would be good for men's running shoes near me or something like that, but the only downside other than the good side is that people type in buy men's running shoes or men's running shoes for sale or for sale. People typing in that, you would show up, your ads would show up for that. But it could also show up for like, why are men's running shoes good? Or, you're getting all sorts of queries based around that, but it's unlikely. You know, if someone's typing in men's running shoes, usually there's some sort of buying intent there. That someone's trying to look for a shop or a category page. Okay, so you have to use your common sense around that. If someone would type this in, what would they expect to see? Think about the intent. What's their intent, right? No one's going to give you the answer. You have to basically collaborate with your marketing team, understand from your Google Ads, are these, you know, even type it into Google and see what the top three search results come up. And then Google will basically say, hey, these are the top three. And this is what we think people are likely wanting. And it's either a blog post or a category page or whatever. Next up, exact match example with the organic coffee beans. So you can see the brackets on either side here, which is really good. Organic coffee beans, if you type that in exactly, then there's likelihood that someone's trying to buy organic coffee beans near them. And if you sold organic coffee beans, that might be a keyword that you want to try out and see. Now, if we go back to this example, real world example, we can see that not all keywords are equal. So for example, the click-through rate or the relatability of your ad is different for each. So this is really high, which is good. This is really high. So people typing in 24-hour plumber, 20%, plumber in Pennington. So these are really relatable. Got a very, very high conversion rate on all of these. And you kind of get an idea based on the service or product that you're pushing on your Google Ads. You need to really hone in on your match types and the keyword that you're bidding on. So, for example, we're very, very particular on our phrase match, the way that we use it, and the exact keyword. We don't want to venture too far out of the likelihood of them taking next action. So this is obviously going to a plumber page and people wanting to take that next step. We want to make sure these keywords are all serving to that purpose, to find someone who is ready to take that next step on Google Ads. So that's a little bit on how to add keywords to Google Ads. It's very, very easy, but more important is not wasting your money and making sure you know the match types. So if you've got any questions, as always, leave a comment below. I'll talk to you soon. Thanks.